reading comes from Daniel chapter 12, verses 1 through 3. At that time, Michael, the great prince, protector of your people, shall arise. It shall be a time of anguish such as never occurred since nations first came into existence. But at that time, your people shall be delivered, who is found written in the book. Many of those who sleep in the lust of the earth, dust of the earth, shall awake, some to everlasting life, and some to shame and everlasting contempt. Those who are wise shall shine like the brightness of the sky, and those who lead many to righteousness like the stars forever. Word of God, word of life. Let's turn to Psalm 16. Responsible. Protect me, O God, for I take refuge in you. I have said to the Lord, you are my Lord, my good news above all others. But those who run after other gods shall have their troubles multiplied. O Lord, you are my portion and my cup, who uphold my lot. I will bless the Lord who gives me counsel, teaches me night after. My heart, therefore, is in my spirit rejoicing. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures evermore. Our second reading comes from every priest stands day after day at his service offering, again and again, the same sacrifices that can never take away sin. But when Christ had offered for all time a single sacrifice for sin, he sat down at the right hand of God. And since then, he has been waiting for his enemy to be made a footstool. For by a single offering, he has perfected all time those who are sanctified. And the Holy Spirit also testifies to us. For after saying, the covenant I will make with those days, says the Lord, I will put my laws into their hearts, and I will write them on their minds. He also adds, I will remember their sins and lawless no more. Where there is forgiveness of you under therefore, my friends, since we have confidence to enter the sanctuary by the blood of Jesus, by the new and living way that he opened for us through the curtain, that is, through his flesh, and since we have a great peace over the house of God, let us approach with a true heart, a full assurance of truth, with our hearts sprinkled clean from an evil world. Let us hold fast to the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who has promised. And let us consider how to help one another to love and be, not neglecting together the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more approaching. Word of God, word of life.